because it's film and the film and the projectors are both 90 years old, anything could happen.
But to tell you more about that format, I would like to introduce the man who is going to be actually projecting for you tonight. His name is Dino Everett, and he is with the USC Hugh Hefner Film Archive. And welcome, Dino.
Yeah. 28mm was the first safety film format designed for the home. And so in 1912, they decided, oh, you know, we want to get movies in the home, but the nitrate film is flammable. So they came up with a non-flammable film, and that way they could bring movies into the home. The problem was it was a really, really expensive system, so only rich people had it. But because so many films were made on 28mm, a lot of the silent films that we have today survives strictly because they were on 28mm.
Everything that could conceivably go wrong this year has gone wrong. And one of the things was, I have four of these.
Okay.
Right? And I had one that I thought worked just as good as this one. Turns out it doesn't. So I was scrambling with the three trying to make a second one and never could make one. It was always like a jumpy picture.
Yeah.
So then at the last minute, I went over to the Victor machine, but it's a different design. So I had to finagle a bunch of things, but it has the original motor, whereas I had these motors rewound.
Okay.
So they're basically like new motors, whereas that's an original one, and it runs for about 3 to 4 minutes, and then it slows down like considerably. So there's no way, it won't run consistently, so... The only way to keep it is going to be to crank it.
You would have never seen 28mm in a theater. It wasn't designed for that. It was basically designed to be projected on like a 30 by 40 inch screen with about like a 30 watt bulb.
You know.
So what kind of a lamp is in these now?
I have a 300 watt halogen, I think.
Like you'd have in an Elmo or an AK,
yeah.
Like a 16mm classroom projector.
Yeah.
None of us would know anything about Perils of Pauline if it wasn't for 28mm, because that's the only way it's ever survived, is on the 28mm cut-down version.
I would say both of these are right around
1918.
Yeah. This one is perfect because it's separated,
yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's really easy. I just slide a lens in there.
Yeah.
But this one,
yeah.
It's like they've tried to compact the size so much
uh-huh.
that the cutout is actually a little bit into the body.
Oh, geez.
So I had to like groove out something just because normally this would be on the front.
Okay.
So I had to groove it out so it could fit on the back
because
otherwise the lens sat off to the side and you only saw half the picture.
Oh, so you're kind of retrofitting things back to the way they should have been. In order to
right,
work in
right.
the first
it's
place.
Like I'm trying, like on this one, I was trying to improve their design. These are both like lenses from an Elmo.
Oh.
So, because the back on the 2-inch, the back glass is wide enough to pick up the whole 28 frame.
Oh, I see.
At USC, we have a technology museum, and the person who set up the museum and myself feel the same way that old technology, it was designed to do something. So just sitting it on a shelf and shining it up is not enough. We need to sort of put it back into action and show people what these things were like.
And this is something you've rigged for?
Yeah, for cooling of the new lamp in this one, because this one's really easy because the whole gate area is open.
Okay.
So I just put this little fan
and
it blows in and keeps
on.
It all cool.
Okay.
But here, the lamp house and everything is like enclosed.
Ah.
And so the air doesn't actually get in there. So I have to shoot the air underneath. And like I put this on for the TSA.
What did we see?
Yeah.
There's a book called The Complete 9.5 Cinematographer by Harold Abbott, and a friend of mine sent me a good quote that he said to read tonight, so I'm going to read it. 9.5 is another one of those weird gauges that you probably don't know anything about. But, okay. Should a breakdown occur during an exhibition, do not get flurried or make all sorts of apologies. Neither mumble some explanation which nobody understands. Above all things, do not lose your temper, but just quietly say, I shan't keep you a minute. And calmly set about rectifying the trouble. By dealing with the trouble frankly and with perfect composure, your friends will hardly notice the interruption. But if you make an exhibition of yourself, not only will your friends feel supremely uncomfortable, but they will talk about it all the way home. So we're going to go forward with that. But yes, just keep playing, and we'll try to get it back up. And because technically, another thing I should point out is that this was so expensive, nobody had two projectors. So I feel fairly certain in saying that this has never been done anywhere in the world before, where somebody has been running a 28 millimeter feature continuously. So we're just going to be watching for, that's about to end. Okay, we'll start. So there'll be some glitches, but remember, it's still going to be better than it was in 1912 because I would have had to completely change the reel. So I hope you enjoy it. I hope it doesn't break, and we'll go.
And in the back of the room on projection, Dino Everett, assisted by David Lawrence. We will now take a short